Okay, we're going to look at how to calculate inventory under the periodic method using FIFO, LIFO, and average cost. We're going to start with FIFO, first in, first out. First in are the first ones we purchased, we assume are the first ones out, which means sold. In means purchased, out means sold. Okay? Beginning inventory is always the first ones in. Okay? And then these were the next ones in, and so forth. And November, in our example, were the last ones in. All right, so let's take a look at the information here. We have 400 units in beginning inventory. We paid 13 bucks a piece. 400 times 13 is 5,200. Then we have these purchases. These units, these costs per unit, multiplied equals these dollar amounts. Beginning inventory plus my four purchases, we had 2,600 units available for sale at a dollar value of 37,100. Now notice here that beginning inventory plus purchases equals cost of goods available is the same for all three methods. What will be different is the dollar values for ending inventory and cost of goods sold. Okay, if there have been price changes throughout the year, these three methods will produce three different sets of results. Now, on December 31st, we did a physical inventory count, and we noticed we had 700 units on hand. If we have 700 units in ending inventory, obviously they weren't sold, so 2,600 units available minus the 700 units, we must have sold 1,900 units. Using FIFO, let's calculate that value. First in, first out. Okay, so beginning inventory, we'll assume we're the first one sold. 400 times 13 is $5,200. Now again, we sold 1,900 units. They're the first 400. We'll assume the next oldest ones from March were sold next. March, 600 units times 1350 equals 8,100. So that's 1,000 units. I still have 900 units to go. So then the next one sold will be the next oldest, which are the June purchases. Okay, 650 at $14 a piece is 9,100. Now, 400 plus 600 plus 650, that's 1,650. I need another 250 units. So the September purchase, I didn't sell all of these. 250 got sold, and that means the other 250 are in ending inventory. I like to call these layers. That layer got split, the September purchase. Okay? So in September, we sold 250 units at $15 a piece. Okay? 15 times 250, 3,750. Okay, here are the 1,900 units that were sold. And the dollar value, and this will be cost of goods sold. Let's go ahead and just add these up real quickly. $26,150. Okay, that is my cost of goods sold. So I'm going to put that down here. $26,150. Now, this is the cost of goods sold equation. Beginning inventory plus purchases equals cost of goods available minus ending inventory equals cost of goods sold. So we can calculate ending inventory by simply subtracting cost of goods available minus cost of goods sold. Let's go ahead and do that. 37,100 minus 26,150 equals 10,950. That's the value of my ending inventory. We can also take what I call the long route, and we call this the proof of ending inventory. Okay, let me put a little separation here. So we know that the dollar value is $10,950. Let's go ahead and prove that it is in fact that. September, If 250 were sold, the other 250 were not sold. So in September, we have 250 at $15 each. That's $37.50. And then the November purchase, 450 units, $16 a piece, is $7,200. And it looks like we have in fact proved ending inventory is $10,950. Okay, and that's how you calculate inventory and cost of goods sold using FIFO in the periodic system.